Let's use relative motion to consider the flight of a plane. A pilot must fly her plane due north to reach her destination. We have some information about how the plane can fly in still air, and a wind is blowing out of the northeast at 90 kilometers per hour. So we want to know what's the speed of the plane relative to the ground and in what direction must we head. So the speed with respect to the ground, I'm going to call VPE. So that's the velocity of the plane with respect to the Earth. And then we'll call this some angle alpha. Draw a diagram to get our mind around what's going on, where we've got north and east specified. We'll say, I need to fly north. So the velocity of the plane with respect to the Earth has to be straight up. We know the wind is coming out of the northeast, so it's blowing to the southwest. And we'll put that at a 45 degree angle. And the magnitude of that is 90. So that means that in order to fly, we have to head upwind a little bit. So we have to point our plane up that way somehow. We need to figure out how much that is. We'll specify this angle in here as alpha and use some other geometry here, alternate interior angles with this 45 degree angle to get this 45 inside plus the 90 degrees. So this interior angle there is 90 plus 45 or 135. And then we've got some unknown angle beta in the corner. This VPW from the problem statement is the plane can fly 300 kilometers per hour in still air. So the velocity of the plane with respect to the wind is 300 kilometers per hour. And our relative motion statement then becomes VPE is equal to VPW plus VWE. So VPW, VWE, the W's related on the inside. So that's how we get that. In other words, VPW plus VWE gives us VPE. Now it's a math problem. So that's the setup. Now we need to solve for VPE, the length of this side of the triangle. We also need to solve for alpha, the angle inside the triangle. There are a few different ways to do that, and I'll show you a couple. We'll start with law of sines. Law of sines says that the ratio of the length of a triangle to the sine of its opposite side is a consistent ratio around the triangle. So if we use this 300 kilometers per hour side, and I know this is not a length, this is a velocity, but it works the same. 300 kilometers per hour over the sine of its opposite angle, 135 degrees, is going to equal this green side divided by the sine of its opposite angle, alpha, 90 kilometers per hour over sine of alpha. And that's also equal to this unknown side, VPE, over the sine of its unknown opposite angle, beta. So we have three unknowns. That's going to be hard with just law of sines. We're going to need to incorporate something else to solve for three unknowns. We can solve for two. The third gets a little tricky. But looking at just these, I think we can equate those and solve for alpha from that. So we'll multiply by sine of alpha, divide by the rest of this stuff, and we get sine of alpha is equal to 90 over 300 times the sine of 135. So again, it's using this relationship and solving for alpha. We can take the inverse sine of both sides, and we get a relationship that we can evaluate to be 12 degrees. So this says that the direction the pilot must fly has to be 12 degrees east of north. So this alpha is 12 degrees. So far, so good, but now we need to solve for either beta or VPE. Luckily, we have some geometry to help us because we have this triangle. We know that this angle is 135, and this angle now we know is 12. So we can sum the angles in a triangle and sum them up to 180. We can now plug in the thing we know for alpha, 12 degrees, and subtract them to the other side to get beta by itself and find that beta then has to be 33 degrees. Now with knowing beta, now we can use this relationship with either this one or this one. It doesn't matter which one we equate it to. We'll go ahead and choose the first one. And we'll solve for VPE. So this is multiplying by sine beta on both sides to cancel it from the right to put it on the left. And we get VPE is equal to that 300 kilometers per hour times the sine of 33 degrees, that's our beta, divided by the sine of 135 degrees. Plugging in numbers and evaluating that, we get 230 kilometers per hour. So the speed of the plane relative to the ground ends up being 230 kilometers per hour, and that's because the wind is slowing us down. So relative to the air, we're still moving at 300 kilometers per hour, but relative to the ground, the plane is moving at 230 kilometers per hour. I promised you a second way. If you're satisfied with this way, you can stop paying attention right now. But the second way is, instead of using law of sines, we break it up into x and y components. So doing x and y components, same setup. Now we'll call x direction to the right, y direction up. And we'll note that this 300 can be resolved into an x and a y component by using that angle alpha. So the x direction, we get the expression of this vector function in the x direction is VPE, the x components of each of these things. And what that means is basically this VPE has no x component, so it'll be 0. VPWX is this 300 sine alpha. And then this VWEX is going to be a negative 90 times cosine of 45 degrees. So we can plug that stuff in. And we have one equation, one unknown. We solve for alpha, and it looks a lot like the other solution. And indeed, it should give us the same number. So that's just looking at the x-directional components of that vector expression. Keep in mind, you have to keep track of what's positive and what's negative when you plug those in. You can do the same thing in the y-direction to find our other thing we care about. What was it? It was VPE. So it only has a y component. So it shows up when we plug this in. And then here, we will now use cosine of alpha for the first term and sine of 45 for the second term. It turns out sine of 45 and cosine of 45 are the same, so that won't matter, but it's just good practice. We can now solve this for the thing that we want to know, which is VPE. We know alpha, so we plug that in, and we end up with our same result as before. So whichever way makes most sense to you, you're most comfortable with, feel free to go ahead and use that.